Thank you, Ty, and thank you all for giving me this wonderful opportunity to make this presentation. Just before getting into the technology, I just want to give some statistics about the pain epidemic. So around 100 million Americans are suffering from pain. Interestingly, 50% of them are not happy with their prescription medication. And every year, we spend $30 billion. If you really put all these facts together, it becomes obvious that in pursuit of pain relief, we are spending $15 billion wastefully every year. If you consider other costs, it may be much more than that. So this really made us wonder, what is going on? Fundamentally, it looks like our approach to pain relief is not right. So we'll come back to that at the end of this presentation. Just to give you the current landscape, if you have pain, either you can go for drugs, or you can go for a physiotherapy or a physical medicine, or procedural, or even cognitive therapy. Of all these, what we recognized is that, if you look at pros and cons, of the treatment and limitations, it's relatively easy to address the physical medicine-based methods than drug-based, because you can't get around adverse side effects, because one way or the other, safety, efficacy, tolerability is compromised. So the moment you take drugs, inevitably you have side effects. So if you really do a head-on comparison with a prescription drug versus physical medicine, whether you take a simple Tylenol, or a narcotic, or an opium tablet, the process is very simple. Take a capsule, gulp it, take what you have done. On the other hand, if you go for a physical method, there are a whole bunch of devices out there. And somebody has to administer it to you. Or there's a learning curve. So that is what really we feel is stopping the people from going away from drugs, although it's much more effective to go for a physical medicine than a drug for pain relief. The cartoon you're seeing is from Time Magazine. From top-notch medical journals to mainstream media, they're saying, just because it's easy to pop a pill, don't take it. There are other alternate methods to manage the pain. So this is where we came up with this applicator. It combines two or three popular physical methodologies out there, because we understand the fundamental pathophysiology in pain relief. And with this applicator, we can precisely target it. So to this end, we made our prototype. We conducted some animal studies. We got very good data, like what we are expecting. And we have done some pilot studies in more than 20 patients. Again, we got fantastic outcome. And we are going for CE marking at the end of this year, and hope to launch the product early next year, and then even go for FDA approval early next year. We have a couple of patents filed on this. So our applicator looks something like this. You can put it wherever you have the pain. It can be used for all kinds of chronic pains. But again, I emphasize, go back to my first slide. One thing we are missing here is pain is a highly subjective and personal experience. There is no silver bullet to it. But what we are trying to do is, we're hoping that popping a pill is good enough, it will solve all your problems. So that is where we're trying to personalize the pain relief. For everything, there is a number to it. If you have blood pressure, high blood pressure, there's a number. High fever, there's a number. High cholesterol, there's a number. But what is your number? Even for sleep, there is a number. What is your number for pain? Even if you say I'm 1 to 10, you say 9, I may say 5. It's very subjective and personal experience. So that is where most of the medication is failing. That is what we really want to address. Our device can accept patient profile, pain symptom, and prescription. Once the therapy is completed, patient can give feedback. All this data is stored and analyzed, and then you can get a personal pain relief. All this with push of a button. So, just before I wrap it up, our team has 100 plus years of experience altogether. I myself have developed a medical product that has been marketed and FDA approved. My colleagues have years of experience in developing electronics and artificial intelligence. Even some of my investors, I worked with them for the past 5 to 10 years. So we have a wonderful team, and we are looking forward to launch up our next year. And I thank you all for your kind attention and for the invitation to be here. Thank you so much.